My bad, Mr. Bulldogs. It's your school nurse, Nurse Michelle. I just wanted to check in and tell you that I miss your smiling faces in the hallways. I hope that you are staying healthy and doing the very best that you can in this unique time. By this time, you've probably heard the word coronavirus. It seems to be everywhere you go, on every TV channel, and all that anyone is talking about. What's true, what's not true, what's new, what's old. But don't worry, that just means that there's a lot of information out there. Here at Bedminster School, the teachers and I wanted to make sure that everyone had everything they need to know about the coronavirus. In this video, we are going to answer that for you. What is the coronavirus? How is it spread? What can you do about it? And where do we go from here?
Now please sit back and enjoy our book. Coronavirus, A Book for Children by Elizabeth Jenner, Kate Wilson, and Nia Roberts. Illustrated by Axel Scheffler. Consultant, Professor Graham Medley. Professor of Infectious Disease, Modeling London, School of Hygiene and Tropical Medicine. The coronavirus is a kind of virus. Viruses are tiny germs that are so small that you can't see them. They are so light that they can float through the air in tiny drops of water, and they can sit on your skin without you feeling them. If some of these germs get inside you, they can use your body to make more germs, and that can make you ill. There are lots of different kinds of coronavirus, and some of them infect people. If you have been infected with one of these coronaviruses, all you probably had was a snotty nose or a cough. But when this completely new coronavirus germ gets inside a human body, it causes an illness called COVID-19. When people talk about catching the coronavirus, they are talking about this illness.
What is the coronavirus?
The coronavirus is a kind of virus. Viruses are tiny germs that are so small that you can't see them. They are so light that they can float through the air in tiny drops of water, and they can sit on your skin without you feeling them. If some of these germs get inside you, they can use your body to make more germs, and that can make you ill. There are lots of different kinds of coronavirus, and some of them infect people. If you have been infected with one of these coronaviruses, all you probably had was a snotty nose or a cough. But when this completely new coronavirus germ gets inside a human body, it causes an illness called COVID-19. When people talk about catching the coronavirus, they are talking about this illness.
How do you catch the coronavirus?
Because this coronavirus is new, scientists don't know everything about it yet. But they think that there are two main ways that people can catch it. Coronavirus germs live in people's throats and mouths. When someone who has the coronavirus coughs or sneezes or breathes out, the germs come out of their mouth in tiny drops of water. Though you can't see the germs, you can sometimes see these tiny drops. In cold weather, they make a cloud of steam, so if someone else accidentally breathes in the air with the coronavirus germs in it, they would probably get the illness. It's easy to get the coronavirus germs from inside your body on your hands when you touch your nose or your mouth. If the person with the coronavirus germs on their hands uses a door, the invisible germs can live on the handle for hours. When someone else opens the door, they get the germs on their hands too. And if they touch their nose or mouth, the germs can get into their body. So you can also catch the coronavirus by touching things that someone with the virus has already touched.
What happens if you get the coronavirus?
Some people, particularly most children, hardly feel ill at all when they get the coronavirus. but they still have coronavirus germs in their body that they could give to someone else by mistake. When they get the coronavirus, lots of people get coughs and a high temperature. Some people also have a headache or aches all over their body. People are usually ill for a few days, but bodies are amazing things. When a new germ like the coronavirus gets into someone's body, their body knows that the germ shouldn't be there and starts killing it. The body has an amazing weapon against viruses called antibodies, tiny cells in your blood that make antibodies to fight each different virus invader. The antibodies catch the viruses, then the blood cells swallow them up and destroy them, and then the person gets better. Each of us has more than 10 billion different kinds of antibody inside us. That means there are more different antibodies in you right now than there are people in the world.
What's it like to be home all the time?
Sometimes being at home with the people you live with can be great fun. You can do things together that you wouldn't normally do when you're at school or when the grown-ups are at work. These are all normal things to feel, and everyone who lives with you probably feels the same way sometimes, even if they try not to show it. The grown-up or grown-ups who look after you might also feel worried. Sometimes they might feel worried about work. Sometimes it might be hard to buy the things that you all need, and that might worry them too. If you are worried, talk about your worries to a grown-up who looks after you. If you're still going to school, maybe you could talk to a teacher. Maybe you could talk to a teacher or someone else in your family on the phone or using a computer or tablet.
So why are people worried about catching the coronavirus?
Nearly everyone has a body that is healthy enough to fight the coronavirus. But there are some people who find it harder because their bodies aren't as strong. They might be people who are more than 70 years old or already have illnesses like cancer that might make their bodies weaker. They need more help to fight the coronavirus. This means they have to go to the hospital and they might need to use a special machine called a ventilator to help them breathe. However, sometimes even this might not be enough to help them get better, and if that happens, then sadly, they might die. That's why these people really need to stay at home, away from anywhere they might catch the coronavirus. They won't be able to have visitors. That might mean you won't be able to go and visit some of your family for a while to help keep them safe.
Is there a cure for the coronavirus?
Most people get better from the coronavirus by themselves, but doctors and scientists want to help everyone do that quickly and safely. Doctors don't have a cure for the coronavirus yet because it is a new illness. Some medicines that doctors already know about might help, so they are trying them out on people who are ill. But even if they don't work, scientists are also working on making completely new medicines for the coronavirus that no one has ever had before. Another thing that scientists are working on is a vaccine. A vaccine is a special medicine that is usually injected into your body while you are healthy. Inside the medicine are weak or dead virus germs. The antibodies in your blood can practice killing these germs so that if you catch that virus, they can start fighting the live virus germs faster. You probably already had some vaccines when you were a baby, so that means you won't get some illnesses. It takes many months to make a new medicine. Before you can give it to lots of people, you have to make sure that it is safe for everyone, so you have to try it out carefully on a few people at a time. Then when you know it works and is safe, you have to make enough for everyone who needs it.
Hola, my friends. Why are some of the places that we usually go to closed?
Although lots of people will get better from the coronavirus, it's really important that people who might become very ill don't catch it. This means we need to make sure that as few people as possible get the coronavirus so that we don't pass it on to anyone who might get very ill. And if lots of people get ill and have to go to the hospital at the same time, then hospitals will get too busy to look after people properly. It's so easy to get the coronavirus that we need to be very careful that we don't get too near people who don't live with us. And that's why all the places where lots of people are together, like schools and libraries, are closed at the moment. The government of this country has said that people can only go outside of their home if they really, really have to. Some people, like doctors or nurses or people who work in food shops or people who deliver things to our homes, have to go out of their home to go to work. Most people can also go out of their home if they need to buy food or to exercise, but they must be very careful not to go near anyone else. If you or anyone in your family feels ill and thinks that they might have the coronavirus, you can't come out of your home at all for 2 weeks. We all have to stay at home to protect the people who will find it hard to fight the coronavirus.
What can I do to help?
You are already helping a lot by staying at home, but you can also help by taking extra care to make sure you don't catch or pass on the coronavirus to anybody else. Did you know that viruses are killed by soap? So if you wash your hands really carefully and for long enough, you won't have any coronavirus germs on your hands. You can sing a song while you wash your hands to make sure you're washing them for long enough. Long enough to sing happy birthday twice. If you have to wipe or blow your nose, use a tissue and put it in the bin straight away. Remember to wash your hands too, because the coronavirus lives in your snot and it can get on your hands from the tissue. If you have to cough or sneeze, do it in the inside corner of your elbow, not in your hand. Then you can't give the coronavirus to other people that way. If everyone does these things, it will make a big difference.
What else can I do?
Another important thing you can do is to be kind to the people that you live with. Things will be different and perhaps difficult for all of you. If you live with brothers and sisters, you might sometimes find them annoying, but try not to fight with them. If you live with grown-ups, maybe you can help them by doing what you've been asked to do or giving them a big hug. If you are not at school, do your schoolwork. It will help to keep your mind busy so you won't be bored, and then when you go back to school, you will have learned a lot. If you don't have a screen of your own, talk about how you can share screen time fairly with everyone who needs it. Remember, grown-ups who live with you might have to do work as well. If they do, you can help them by not disturbing them when they are trying to work. Then they will be more likely to have time to do fun things with you. Maybe you could make a list of things that you would like to do with them.
What's going to happen next?
This time is a strange time for everybody, and it's happening all over the world. But if we are all careful and we all stay at home, we are doing what we can to stop the coronavirus spreading. And that gives the scientists and doctors time to work out how to cure the illness and maybe stop people getting it altogether by using medicines and vaccines. One day, quite soon, though nobody knows exactly when, you'll be able to visit people you love who don't live with you, play with your friends, go to school again, and do lots of other things that you enjoy, but that you can't do now. One day, this strange time will be over.
We did it together.
Nous l'avons fait ensemble. We did it together.
We did it together.
We did this together.
We did it 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 together.
This publication was made available by Noisy Crow, an independent children's publisher based in London. For more information about Noisy Crow or how to get your copy of this book, please visit noisycrow.com.